Welcome to World Tech Update. I'm Martin Williams, and this week we're coming to you from Barcelona in Spain and Mobile World Congress. It's the annual get-together of the world's cell phone industry, and the big news this week has been new cell phones and new operating systems. In particular, Microsoft's debut of Windows Phone 7 series, the new version of Windows Mobile. The new OS represents a complete rewrite and redesign of Windows Mobile. The home screen consists of live tiles, icons that update with information from the internet. Six of the tiles lead to what Microsoft calls hubs, menu areas that collect data together based around functions. For example, the People hub consolidates phone contacts, friends on Facebook and Windows Live, email addresses, and information about these people. Phone numbers, mail addresses, and social media status updates are also there. Another hub does the same for images.
I'm going to touch the Pictures tile right here and navigate in. And this part of the hub is the gallery, where I can view all the pictures that are available for me to look at on my phone. I'm going to pan to the right, and the phone has picked the latest album of pictures that I synced from my PC or that I've taken with the phone camera, so they're available for quick viewing. I'm going to pan to the right, and again, a What's New feed that shows you all of the activity of my friends as it relates to photos.
Windows Mobile has been showing its age in recent years, and the new OS steps up the competition against rivals like Apple and Google.
I'm enthusiastic about the direction that we're headed. It's a step, it's a big step, but together with top talent inside Microsoft and the best talent that we get a chance to work with at companies like Orange and AT&T and others, I think we really get a chance to have a major impact on the market.
Nokia and Intel announced plans to merge their mobile operating systems together into MeeGo, a Linux-based open OS that will be targeted at everything from cell phones to set-top boxes.
MeeGo blends the very best of Moblin and MIMO software into one Linux-based computing platform.
The first version of MeeGo will ship during the second quarter and is targeted at much more than just phones.
MeeGo will be targeting a wide range of devices. This includes pocketable mobile computing devices, as well as netbooks, tablets, connected TVs, media phones, and in-vehicle infotainment systems.
Now, it will be Mobile World Congress without lots and lots of new cell phones. A couple of the big announcements of the week, Sony Ericsson had new versions of its X10 Xperia cell phone. Size is what sets these two Android-based phones apart. The X10 Mini comes in two versions, one with a QWERTY keyboard and one without, and will start shipping in some markets outside the US in the second quarter. US launch plans are yet to be decided. The Xperia X10 Mini will cost around €350, that's around $475, and the Pro version about €20 more. Sony Ericsson has put just four application buttons on the small screen, one in each corner, to make them as easy to reach as possible.
You have four corners, and just with your thumb, you can use all the functionality of the product.
The phones also have Timescape, Sony Ericsson's application for keeping track of text messages, missed calls, and Facebook and Twitter updates. As you can imagine, there's a lot of competition for the attention of journalists here. At exactly the same time as Sony Ericsson's press conference, Samsung was unveiling Wave, a phone based on its Batter platform. The phone's most eye-catching feature is a 3.3-inch OLED screen that offers richer colors than the LCD screens found on many other cell phones. The screen is protected by a piece of tempered glass that has an anti-smudge coating, so users shouldn't have to spend too much time cleaning off fingerprints. The S8500 Wave will cost €320, that's around $435, and will begin shipping in April in Europe, and then in most other parts of the world in May. However, availability in the US is still yet to be decided. And during a Mobile World Congress keynote, Google CEO Eric Schmidt announced plans to put Flash into Google's Android operating system. With it, the company's hoping to get a leg up over Apple, which doesn't include Flash in the iPhone, and Microsoft, which won't have Flash in Windows Phone 7 series when it ships later this year.
So what I want to give you a sneak preview of today is Flash running on Android. And here you see an image that many of you are probably familiar with, the New York Times. But as you scroll around, you can see that all the components are there, including the videos. And I'm just going to zoom in here, take a look at this video of a logger, and why don't we just start playing that video. So one tap, this is actually just now buffering. everyone here, get off Wi-Fi.
That's right.
Well, as this is buffering.
Now, the New York Times demo never did run properly, but we did see Flash in another demonstration, so we know that it was in the phone. Cell phones haven't been the only thing in the news this week. There has been more happening, and Nick is in Boston with the rest of the week's news. Nick?
Thanks, Martin. We'll start with a new concept car announced by Swiss auto tuner Rinspeed that it plans for the upcoming Geneva Motor Show in March. The UC, or Urban Commuter, is a small 2.6-meter electric vehicle designed for city driving. According to Rinspeed, drivers can expect a range of around 105 kilometers and a top speed of 120 kilometers an hour. 50 kilometers of driving will take about 2 hours of charging or 20 minutes on a higher voltage outlet. In place of a steering wheel, drivers will find a force feedback joystick connected to a drive-by-wire system. The cockpit is centered around a large 3G-enabled touchscreen computer that supports voice over IP, video chat, and email. For longer trips out of the city, drivers can book train passage for their UC right from the 3G dashboard. While Rinspeed said it would like to bring the car to market, they haven't announced any plans. The 2010 Toy Fair was on this week in New York City, and here's a quick look at some of the coolest stuff we found. First up, we saw the shirt guitar from ThinkGeek.
That's pretty amazing. How does that work?
There's a little magnet within this pick.
Okay.
And there's a detector here around the pickups.
Uh-huh.
It detects every time you pass the pick over top. And the buttons just determine which chord is being strung.
The shirt lets you play all major chords, and included is a mini guitar amp that you can clip to your belt. The shirt goes for $30 and is available now. Next up is the Spy Video Tracker, which is a remote control car that relays video and audio back to the remote. It captures and records VGA video, has night vision and motion detection, but is also completely open source and programmable.
Okay. So they can go to our program modulator, they can tweak and modify apps that already exist, or they can completely build their own. We're going to have a development kit that takes them through the programming language. It'll be in C and C++. Once they make their apps, there's going to be an online community where they post them. Mm-hmm. There's no charge to download other people's apps. We're not monetizing off that.
The Spy Video Tracker will hit shelves in October for $120. Well, that's all from me here in Boston. I'll be on vacation next week, so Martin will be back, although I may be making a special appearance, so stay tuned. For now, it's back to Barcelona.
Thank you, Nick. Now, that's all the time we have for you this week, but come back to World Tech Update next week, and we'll be taking a look at some of the other cell phones that were unveiled here at Mobile World Congress. And then in a couple of weeks, we're on the road again in Germany at CeBIT, so watch out for that. But on behalf of everyone at the IDG News Service, I'm Martin Williams saying thanks for watching, and goodbye from Barcelona in Spain.